Good afternoon, everyone. Today we'll discuss about complications of fractures. Complications of fractures are pathophysiological conditions that could be associated with certain fractures. And why it is important to learn about complications? What is the importance of complications? Complications are important because they could be life-threatening and they must be recognized earlier, diagnosed properly, and must be treated aggressively to save the limb or life of the patient. We can classify complications on the basis of locality. Complications could be localized or generalized. Localized means they are restricted to injured limb or the site of fracture. Generalized means involvement of multiple systems could be there apart from musculoskeletal system. Further, we can classify local complications. It could be immediate complication, means at the time of fracture or at the time of injury would be there. Early complications means within 3 weeks of duration after the injury. And late complications after 3 weeks, even after months or years, would be late complications. Today we'll go for local complications. First, immediate local complications could be a major vessel injury like popliteal or brachial artery injury could be there. Nerve injury could be there, which is very close to fracture site. Most common is radial nerve injury in fracture shaft of the humerus. Joint injury could be there, just close to joint damage may be there because of certain fractures. Visceral organ could be damaged, for example, in pelvis injuries. Let's see. Vascular injury, most common vascular injury is brachial artery in supracondylar fractures of the humerus. Popliteal artery is injured in proximal tibial fractures. Nerve injury, that could be either neuropraxia, means physiological interruption of nerve function because of entrapment at the fracture site. Exonotmesis could be there because of contusion of the nerve. Some sort of axonal injury is there. Neurotmesis, complete transection of the nerve, could be there. So most common nerve injuries are radial nerve, which is most commonly seen in fracture shaft of the humerus, and sciatic nerve, seen in fracture dislocation of the hip. These are certain examples of common nerve injuries seen in clinical practice. For example, shoulder dislocation is associated with axillary nerve injury. Fracture humerus is associated with radial nerve injury. Supracondylar fracture may be associated with radial or median nerve injuries. Medial epicondyle of the humerus could lead to ulnar nerve injury. Montagia fracture dislocation is commonly associated with posterior intraosseous nerve injury, and hip dislocation could be associated with sciatic nerve injury. And visceral injury, which is commonly seen in pelvic fractures, for example, urethral injury, that is very common in pubic diastasis or certain pelvic fractures. Now, early complications. Early means within 3 weeks. Compartment syndrome is the early complication of certain fractures. For example, supracondylar fracture of the humerus or tibial plateau fractures or proximal tibial fractures. Compartment syndrome is a clinical entity that is manifested by certain clinical features because of raise in the pressure of compartment. Compartment means osteofacial compartment space containing muscles, neurovascular structures. So because of swelling or because of edema inside the compartment, pressure would be raised, leading to compromise of neurovascular structures and necrosis of the muscle. Let's see. This is the compartment of leg. This one is osteofacial compartment. Osteo means bones. Fascia is connected to form compartments containing certain muscles and neurovascular structures, nerves and vessels, capillaries of muscles as well. So raise in the pressure because of swelling or because of ischemia would lead to raise in the pressure of compartment that would further create edema, and vicious cycle would be there. So there would be compromise of neurovascular structures, leading to necrosis of the muscle. Let's see. Which compartment? Common compartments are, which are involved in compartment syndrome, are forearm and leg. Other compartments, hand, finger, gluteal region, thigh and foot. So these are osteofacial compartment, could be involved with certain fractures. This is pathophysiology of compartment syndrome. Because of edema and ischemia, vicious cycle would be there and would lead to necrosis of the muscle. So clinically, clinical features are pain would be there, severe pain would be there, paresthesia, numbness would be there because of compression of nerves, pallor because of ischemia, because of compression of vessels in that region, paralysis could be there, difficult movements, pulselessness would be there, means pulse would be feeble in distal part of the limb. Treatment part, simply we have to elevate the limb, remove any tight bandaging or cast around the limb. In certain cases, if it is not controlled with all these conservative treatment, we need to go for surgical intervention, fasciotomy, to release the pressure of the compartment. This is an example of fasciotomy in the leg. Fascia is released and compartment is relieved. So it would improve the circulation of muscle, and if it is viable, then it would be revived. This is example of fasciotomy in the forearm region with same basic principles. Another, and we'll go for late complications in next time. Okay, let's see. Thank you.